heater from Home Depot. I found the reviews. There was only one bad review, it looked like. It had over a 4.8 or 4.9 for the review. Compared to all the other heaters that they had in stock, this was the best one for the garage. It requires a two-pole breaker, 30 amp. And when you have 30 amp, you need 10 gauge wire. So I have all that. Do the unboxing. I'll show you what you need. Okay, so this is 10 gauge wire. Okay, you also need a two-pole 30 amp breaker. Get the breaker that's compatible with your panel. You'll need a 30 amp double pole switch, and you need a junction box for the switch. Technically, you don't need the switch. You can hardwire it directly and use the switch on the heater, but I like the idea of being able to flip the switch on and off at a lower level since I'm going to have the heater mounted up high. So this is the switch. It's not too heavy. Okay, you always have to make sure that there's a note the heater is equipped with an automatic fan delay control. Fan will not operate until heating element is hot. Okay, and then so what they're telling you is that the fan will continue to run until the heating element is cool, which is good. And they're just giving you a warning that the fan may go on and off if it's very cold until it gets up to temperature. Sounds to me like they didn't build enough hysteresis into the switch. Okay, mounting hardware. It's L1 and L2, that's line 1, line 2 for the 220. So I'll probably wire a Romex connector in from the side. All right, L1, L2, and ground. So there's the ground screw. In case you can't see it, we'll get you in a little bit closer. L1, there's a screw here for the terminal block. L2, screw here for the terminal block and the ground screw. Okay, I got a 3/8 socket. Okay, I'm loosening both sides. I'm not taking it off. Up. It'll pop off. So now we're going to knock it out here, so we can get the wire in. Okay, we have this knockout taken off. Plus we have this, clamp it on the inside. Okay, so this is 10 gauge wire. Remove the insulation. They gave a little card with a description. Sounds like maybe there's an issue, so we're just going to double check all the wiring. So this ground wire, we need to make sure that it is out of the way. So we'll just bend it over around here. So we have this screw here. All right, so now we can close this lid. Nope, this is double check. This card had this in here for a reason, so let's double check everything. For correct fan operation and heater performance, it is important that prior to initial test or operation of this heater, that you recheck your field wiring and the location of the jumper wires on each terminal block. So 5,000 watts. Okay, so now we can close this lid. Right up in this area, and we're gonna have the switch right here. All right, we got lag bolts. I have this guy here, so now we gotta find the mounting point. Hopefully this will come out in the camera. You have line, which means that is the supply, the power supply and load. This goes to the load side. So this that I'm hooking up here is the load. Connected, everything looks fine. Now we're gonna work on this panel. Turn off him, and I'm gonna cut power to this panel. So now this panel is de-energized. All right, we're gonna come from underneath. It's gonna be on this side, so I'll probably knock you out here. Okay, Romex connector. These two screws I'm tightening. Okay, right now I'm just stripping the wire. And this guy I'm gonna cut short. So this is a 30 amp double pole breaker, and what that means is that when you flip this switch to on, it energizes both of these at the same time to two different phases. Okay, so now he's plugged in. Okay, there's a little terminal screw right here. Insert the wire.
Okay, so we're taking out these.
So now the panel is centered. Power. This guy, energize him. Got power there. All right, so I just turned the... Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. There we go. Now this, they said that the fan will come on and off a couple times as it heats up.